Hi, I'm Borja. Welcome to La Muela, Europe's largest pump storage facility.
Welcome to Enlit on the Road. La Muela is part of the Cortes-La Muela hydroelectric complex. Can you give me an idea of the scale and the capacity of this complex?
Yes, thank you, Julia. The total capacity in generation is 1800 megawatts, with a total output power in pumping mode of 1500 megawatts. The total investment Iberdrola did in this complex is 1.2 billion euros. And now this complex is the largest pumping storage hydroelectric plant in Europe. We always talk about La Muela like a giga battery. La Muela is connected to the transmission system in Spain. This kind of complex allows the integration of, for example, solar or wind technologies. We use the surplus energy when there is low demand in the system to pump water from the lower reservoir to the upper one. We use the water we have stored in the upper reservoir to produce energy when the system requires it. During peaks of great demand, La Muela can act as a traditional hydroelectric power plant and gives stability and quality to the system, adjusting the generation and the demand. We can go in La Muela from the minimum power to the full power in a matter of seconds.
I can imagine that the increase of renewable energy in the energy mix maybe changes the way La Muela functions. How is this influencing the operation of the dam?
That's a really good point, Julia. Because a long time ago, we had a cycle per week in this asset. And nowadays, we are talking about two or three different cycles. Why? Because the number of megawatts of non-manageable renewable technologies in the system has increased a lot. So that's the reason why this kind of assets, this technology of pump storage, it's very important for the system. Because we give stability and we give firm energy.
It can't be easy to run such a big battery, so to say. What are the biggest challenges in operating La Muela?
I would say the biggest challenge for us is to reduce the time of the maintenance to maximize the availability of the power plant. So every unit is ready when it is needed.
Since this is such a unique technology, how do you find the right skills to operate the dam?
Our staff is 100% in-house, so all the maintenance is carried out by our staff. We have in-house training programs to teach our people to be ready when the time comes.
Valencia was hit by extreme rainfall and flooding at the end of 2024. How has that influenced the operations of the dam?
To be honest, it was a really difficult day for everybody. In the case of hydro business, we could manage everything properly in our dams and in our hydro plants, because we have our staff well-trained. We have special training programs in Madrid. So thanks to that, everything went fine.
What was the role of the dam in assisting with the energy challenges coming from the flooding in the city?
This kind of pump storage facilities are very important in days like that, because there were problems in many transmission and distribution lines. We have to think that La Muela hydropower plant provides energy for a lot of households every year. So that day, it was very important to give stability and safety to the system. So that's why the system operator requested us to start our turbines and to produce energy as soon as possible. In a question of 3-4 minutes, we were at full power. It's important to have a different mix of different energies to avoid a blackout.
In this case, La Muela was able to come to the rescue in this case of extreme weather and a climate disaster. Is La Muela itself at risk of being influenced by climate change?
Not really. I mean, to be honest, in this case, we are in a closed loop, so we don't have any water consumption, so we can use the water as many times as we want. We are not affected by the climate condition. If we are talking about periods of drought, this is a good opportunity also to avoid those conditions.
Tell me about the building of the plants and how does it work?
The building of the first phase started in early 80s, and in 1988, they finished the commissioning of Cortes Dam and Cortes Power Plant. In 1989, they finished our upper reservoir. In 2015, they finished the construction of the second phase of La Muela. When they built the first phase, they took a very good decision that made the work quite easier for us later, that they decided to build the water intakes for both phases. In the upper reservoir, they built two water intakes, and in the lower reservoir, they also built two water intakes. So when we built the second phase, we only had to build the underground cavern and the penstock, also underground, and other auxiliary services. We have a surface penstock in the first phase, and we have an underground penstock for the second phase. We built the second penstock underground because we wanted to reduce the environmental impact. We have a net head of 500 meters between the upper reservoir and the lower reservoir. Both turbines are Francis. We have three different units in phase one and four units in phase two. We are thinking about the third phase. We think it's going to be critical for a sustainable system, and we want to go for more renewable in the system. It's completely necessary. So we are very interested in developing new pump storage. We have very important assets here in Spain, also in the north of Portugal. We have just commissioned a new pump storage in the north of Portugal, very similar to La Muela. So we could say La Muela is the crown jewel.
Borja, you've been working in hydropower for 18 plus years. Why are you so passionate about this?
Every hydropower plant is unique, different, and they are located at very beautiful places like this.
Mm-hmm.
And besides, the hydro technology is stable technology, sustainable technology, and we are green energy.
If we put La Muela in the context of the Spanish energy transition, why is this plant important for the renewable energy outlook for Spain?
Yeah, we are going to a huge electrification in the system, and it's very important to be able to integrate these non-manageable renewable technologies that this kind of assets like La Muela can do.
Thank you very much for sharing your insights. For more insights, join the Enlit community.